own. We are bound to others, past and present. And by each crime and every kindness, we birth our future.
One of the things that I love is how easy it is to lose track of who's who in the film. Like, you really vanish into it.
Mm. That's good. Because you shouldn't be spending the whole film trying to figure out who's in what drag.
And you don't really. I mean, that's a part of it. But all six stories kind of come into one wonderful focus, you know, increasingly as the film progresses. And so each story is fascinating in its own way, and yet they start to, and you're following each one of them individually. None of them are difficult to follow,
right?
But watching them all at once, you might think that, but that ride and that journey gets increasingly kind of wild and wonderful, I think, as the film goes on.
Well, I think that's what the structure, that's what their version of the structure did, is it becomes a real emotional 45 minutes towards the end, where it's just this crescendo.
So stories are paralleling each other. Yeah. You've got all chase sequences in each, you know, so tonally there are similarities.
I think your intellect is alert and sane, because you rarely go into a movie where you don't know in the first 5 minutes what kind of movie it is.
Exactly.
So in the beginning, your intellect's like, I'm going to figure this out. And then what happens is the emotion of the characters, the longing of the characters, the need for freedom, the need for love, whatever it is that drives each story, it starts to seem familiar. And then when you see it, it's the second time, you see the clever editing and how they dovetail and how the music moves you. And so it becomes of one piece that strangely tells you that as human beings, however different we are, underneath all our stories are basically the same.
Having Tom write the music and having the music be available at the beginning of the thing, that sextet is such a powerful piece.
Yeah, it sure is.
And it's really, I think
it's absolutely beautiful. And we had that first reading we had when just before we read through it, we had these images of the whole film up on the wall from beginning to end, images from each scene. We hadn't shot it yet, but there were sort of costume design ideas, other images which might be pertain to a particular scene. So we walked all the way through that and then played Tom played the music. So we got a sense of the sweep of the piece and the emotion of the piece and the polyphonic nature of the piece. And then we sat down and read it, and David Mitchell, the writer, was there, and Lana and Andy and Tom all read little roles. And then everyone kind of launched into this, suddenly you're realizing, oh, so that actors playing these roles, and you're hearing different voices coming from the same actor, and then increasingly as the film went on, you're getting a sense of that one soul through the piece. It was a genuinely thrilling thing.
And I think that maybe also to see the people makes it easier even than the book. Because you don't have to say, now, wait a minute, who is that character? You know, you're just in each piece, and you kind of surrender to that.
And each story is set up very quickly before the credits.
I think the chronology each one of the story. Is
and so as soon as you're back with say, the Louisa Ray story, she's announced who she is and what she's up to in this nuclear facility and what's going on. And so she asks a question. And when you're back with her, oh, that's right, that's that story. Each story sets itself up, and you're back with it quite quickly. So quite quickly you start to follow each story individually. Mm. That's not difficult.
Find out what's next in movies, music, and TV at hitfix.com.